I request all the participants to join with the meeting link that is shared in the WhatsApp group. We'll start the session now. As we had a speaker, Professor S.S.V.N. Sharma sir, sir will be delivering a session. He's a resource person for the session, that is overview of artificial intelligence and machine learning. I request sir to take up the session.
Thank you. Shall I start, Tanvir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are ready.
Thank you very much. Most of the participants, I hope, Tanvir, they are all faculty members.
Yes, sir. We are all the participants are from the.
Therefore, today I will use my experience, my little experience, which may not be so much valuable. But I want to use my experience how to start this artificial intelligence subject to a student who is mostly worried about the subject and its content. Now, if we make it very serious in talking about so many non-abstract things and abstract things, the student gets little bit confused. Therefore, I would like to take the personal examples and then move forward about what this artificial intelligence is. I don't want to talk about who invented it, what are the applications. Let us not, because already half an hour has been eaten away from my session. Therefore, I will confine to how to introduce this subject to a layman in our classrooms. Now, the major advantage of human being is to sense. All of you know, we have five senses. With our mouth, we can eat and we can speak. With our nose, we can breathe and smell. With our ears, we can hear. With our eyes, we can see and show our feelings. With our hand, we can touch and feel our touch to others. So here, what is happening? At every moment of time, we are gathering information. All of us are gathering information. We do not know from the time of birth till our death how much trillions of tons of information we are gathering from different sources. And for all these sources, the most important organs are eyes, nose, ears, touch, and your tongue and mouth. Now, what is happening? Every information, if it is useful to us, we are retaining it. And if it is not useful, we are discarding. We are discarding it, but we are not completely removing from the hard disk of our brain. It is there in our brain, but mostly we don't use it. Every information which we store and we feel that is important is what our term is, it is called knowledge. So there is some knowledge gathering is there in us. Second thing, most important thing is, after gathering knowledge, we are trying to search what is there in that knowledge and what this particular knowledge which we have collected will help us to gain new knowledge. That means we are not only searching, but we are using the present knowledge and then searching for the new knowledge. If somebody asks me a question, what is human being is doing, then my answer is, he is storing and then searching. That's all. We are storing the information and later we are searching the information. And we are using this stored information to gain new knowledge. That is, we are trying to search new things. This is only the difference between animals and human being. Animals always they search, but we have the capacity of storage. We have the capacity of what is called differentiating between useful and non-useful knowledge. What a wonderful creation the God has created. That's why people will call us as naturally intelligent. We are, I don't say natural intelligence word is coined, but people say he is intelligent. But I coined the word natural intelligence because we are talking about artificial intelligence. In natural intelligence, only two things are there. One is storage. Second is using some rules to extract the information from the storage and also for searching for new storage, new information. So database is being stored in our brain, number one. Number two, we know how to use the database for other purpose. That means, let me use the word data structure here. We are using reasoning power to apply that knowledge which we have gained to gain new knowledge. So, can I define intelligence as knowledge plus reasoning power? Knowledge plus reasoning power. Knowledge without reasoning power is not intelligence. Intelligence, reasoning power without knowledge is not intelligence. So this is very clear concept. So we can tell to a student, look, gentlemen, you are gaining knowledge. Now you have to use it after you enter into your life. We will tell in every class, we tell like this. We tell them that we are going to use this knowledge. And if time comes, you have to use it appropriately. If not, there will be loss. Use it very judiciously. So many things we tell. That means an intelligent man is a person who has knowledge plus reasoning power. Reasoning power means power to apply that knowledge for gaining new knowledge or for helping others or using. Then what is knowledge? That is also a very important thing. Every information is knowledge. As a matter of fact, every information is a knowledge. Suppose I put my hand on a hot plate, it burns. So if I put my hand on hot plate, it burns. It is a knowledge. It is a fact. It is a not only belief, it is a fact. This fact will become belief in your life. And every time, whenever you come across a hot plate, immediately you will stop there because you have a belief, you have gained a knowledge that there is a truth that your hand will burn. So we have beliefs, we have hypotheses, we have facts, and these facts we experience daily. And after some days, we say that this is knowledge. Good. So I have defined knowledge in a short span, very short span. Even dog has a knowledge. Every day, particular time, suppose the owner is feeding the dog, immediately at that time it will come. It has limited knowledge. So knowledge, we have got. Now, why artificial intelligence? That's very important. The name looks to be a little bit odd, artificial. Yes, it is artificial. Why it is artificial? It is artificial because we pump in the knowledge, we create the knowledge base, and we put it in the chip or in the memory. And we create rules, and then we ask the other either machine or anybody, to act as per that rules only. That's why it is not natural intelligence, naturally. Because if it is natural intelligence, if there is some chance, you will try to escape. But here there is no question of escape. You have to follow rules. A stack, last in, first out. Suppose you say to a student that you must be following last in, first out. If we just do not see properly, he will escape, and somebody in the back also will come and go back. So we have to create an environment where rule is scrupulously followed. Very clearly the rule has to be followed. That's why we are not allowing to deviate from the rules. Whereas human being always deviates from rules. If there is a chance, we are going to deviate. If so, students, teacher is not taking attendance daily for 1 week, the student try to escape from the class. He will come from attendance. Some students will come from only attendance. He will not be bothered about losing knowledge. Whereas if you create an artificial one situation wherein automatically, if you are not attending, absent mark will be there, then that would be a situation wherein artificial intelligence comes into picture. A limited domain, the domain is limited. Suppose I talk about, say, a robot cleaning the house. Its domain is fixed. In that domain only it will work. And the rules will be applied only to those domains. So with that domain, with that rules, in that domain, you are asking to work that cleaner, to act accordingly, according the rules you have prepared. This is what is called artificial intelligence. So for artificial intelligence, knowledge collection must be there. Domain must be prescribed naturally. Suppose you are teaching to a student, you must tell him, suppose there is a meeting in your college. So for that meeting, what is required, what time is there, you will fix up a domain, and in that domain, that meeting will be working out. So it is also a sort of intelligence act. That's wonderful. So a knowledge is being created, and then knowledge is being used, and you are getting output. Now the question, do you know the output or not? Without knowing the idea of output, you cannot create artificial intelligence. For a human being, without knowing output also, you can do an experiment. But for an artificial intelligence, there is a route and there is a path, and that path only the work has to be done. So the output factor must be defined, the input factor must be defined, the domain must be defined, knowledge problem must be defined, and then you have to ask to work out as per the data structure, as per those rules. This is what artificial intelligence is, very simple. If you go on talking about so many things to a student, he will get confused. Let him tell, compare human brain with an artificial intelligence created brain. Ask him to see a refrigerator. It works in its domain. You cannot ask refrigerator to cook because it has, its domain is fixed, and it has only the thermostat which can cool, that's all. Now the question, how do we represent the knowledge? That's very important. This is where the teacher has to reach the students. Practically speaking, the complete human being, we have got several ways of representing knowledge. Several ways we can represent knowledge. We can show our displeasure with our hands, with our eyes, on a paper with language, different languages, and with our expressions. We have got so many ways of representing knowledge. In an office, if a student goes to a principal, he will ask to write what he wants on a piece of paper, either in English or Telugu or something. So he is representing his knowledge on that paper, and based upon that papers, the principal gains knowledge about what he wants, and then he will give his ruling. So there is a mechanism for a naturally intelligent man to express his or to show his knowledge, represent his knowledge. Then you have your chips, bits, etc. So in many ways you can represent knowledge. But in artificial intelligence, how do you represent a knowledge? That's very important. Is it in English language, or is it in a bits and bytes language, or is it in any other language, or is it through figures, or is it through any other mechanism? How does a robot senses the atmosphere, the location, or the environment, and how does it translates, how the translated thing gets retranslated to understand? What type of knowledge we have to create? The most important thing is we must have the capacity of representing knowledge. For that one, we need what a knowledge can do, first of all. If you want Sharma sir to be associated with you, the first question you will ask, if I associate Sharma sir, what he can do to us and what we can do to them? This is also with knowledge. Knowledge is an entity. It has attributes. It has got certain attributes, and those attributes are to be clearly understood. What are the attributes of knowledge? Knowledge must be finite in case of artificial intelligence. Otherwise, for natural intelligence, we don't say that it must be finite. That's why when we teach finite automata, we call the subject itself as finite automata. Everything is finite. Inputs are finite, outputs are finite, domain is finite, say output function is finite, everything, and we named the subject as finite automata. Similarly, here, the knowledge has to be represented, but knowledge qualities, what are the qualities of knowledge? Knowledge must be always, it must infer. It must inherit. These two things, most important thing. Knowledge must inherit. That means if new knowledge comes, the old knowledge must be in a position to re-correct it or re-edit itself or add it to the existing knowledge. Human being, generally we don't accept. Suppose we think we are right, even though we are not correct, we don't accept it. That mechanism should not be there in artificial intelligence. In artificial intelligence, the knowledge must be in a position to inherit. You know what is inheritance? Already existing knowledge is there. If you can use it and develop new knowledge, that's wonderful. That's an inheritance. And infer. Your knowledge must give some idea to other knowledge. And also you must understand what other knowledge is. So you have to create knowledge for inference purpose and for inheritance purpose, for both the things. So these are the most important things which a student must understand or a teacher must understand while teaching this subject of artificial intelligence. Very typical question is, are you able to understand what exactly knowledge can do it? Next, what is that how to initiate knowledge? We have to think. There is knowledge, no doubt. But how to initiate it, how to use it? There are many people in our society who have knowledge, but they do not have the technique of using it. Now we have to create an artificial intelligence machine in such a way that our knowledge, if it can help it or if it can initiate some action, it must have some what is called attributes. So what are the other attributes? First of all, in any knowledge, initial state must be there. All of you might be teaching finite automata. In that also, you will talk about initial state. Your data structure, we talk about it. That is also initial step is there. Database management, initial step is there. Network theory, initial step is there. Gentlemen, artificial intelligence, you are already doing in all these subjects without your knowledge. So first of all, initial state must be clearly in a knowledge where to start. It must be clearly understood. It must be clearly it must be given a chance, which is the initial state we need to understand. And at least what is your final goal? It has also to be understood. Then only we call it as intelligent machine. A student coming to college, he must have a final goal. At least what is going to come, if he has not definite idea about his final goal, at least what is going to happen. Second thing, there must be a control strategy. Control strategy means strategy, you know, set of rules. How to start the experiment, how to start the machine, and how to, in what path it has to go to get the result. Oh, this is just like that. Just like bringing a servant maid, training her, and then asking her to work to us. In training class, we teach them how to wash the utensils, how to clean the, we will teach him. And she has to work as per our teachings, as per our rules. There must be some control strategy. So, if you can have this idea about artificial intelligence, if you can create, first of all, let us have an idea. What is intelligence and what is artificial intelligence and what is knowledge? We need to understand how you can do it. This is known as, I have made a very big definition of artificial intelligence, but I'm reducing it to a simple thing. Knowledge is there and set of rules are there. You have to act. For that, there is an initial state is there, final goals are there, and there is paths. Paths means after each step, which step has to be taken? After each step, which step has to be taken? Now, gentlemen, when you are teaching to a student, you can also tell him, look, gentlemen, you have already studied searching process. You have already studied how to store the information. You have studied, because they would have already have the component of database management, data structures, network theory, etc., etc. Now he knows how to store them. Second thing, he has already done the a bit of data structures. Therefore, he will be knowing what rules must be applied on that one. So if he can understand that, then very clearly he is now equipped with what artificial intelligence is. So the best method of giving the idea of artificial intelligence is, first of all, tell them, because of the time factor, I'm not deeply involving myself in what is exactly knowledge, how to do it. So many examples are there, but let me confine to the lecture, only 1 hour lecture. That's why knowledge, how to create. And he must be given what is known as difference between databases and knowledge. Knowledge is a database, but database is not knowledge. From database, we extract knowledge. We extract knowledge, no doubt about it. But in database, I say, Sharma sir, age 65. That's all. That's only simple knowledge it is giving. There is an entity, Sharma, who has an age of 60, 70. That's all. Now, with this 70, with Sharma sir, what extra information has to be done? That is knowledge. Then I am just leaving it here because I told you that time is factor. Now let me have you about a little what is known as a little present. I don't say presentation, but let me have it in a simple factor. So there are several what is known as components in artificial intelligence: reasoning and problem solving, knowledge representation. Third is planning. Intelligence, now here, the word intelligent agent, it is very important in artificial intelligence. To any human being, the agents are eyes, nose, mouth, hand, etc. Similarly, for an artificial intelligence machine, there are some intelligent agents, sensors, or some other readers, or some other things. And these sensors, they must set goals and make plans to achieve those goals. So this is planning. In intelligence, planning is very important factor. You must tell to a teacher or any person who is practicing artificial intelligence, for giving a lecture tomorrow, we are planning our lecture today. Similarly, for an artificial intelligent machine, it must have a plan. So the planning must be done. Next is learning. What is learning? What we are doing as an intelligent people, what we are doing. Every day, we are using our background knowledge to gain new knowledge. I have passed an intermediate. From there, I have used that ground to acquire the knowledge of BTech first year, second year, then BTech, MTech. Then after coming to the position of a faculty, every day I go to class, after seeing the faces of the students, if they have got doubts, I will get doubt. Therefore, I would like to clear his doubt, and therefore, immediately I will go to my house and study it. That means my past experience is making me to learn new things, and this is called learning. Through experiences, we start learning, a very important aspect. In artificial intelligence, we have got the learning process also. Gentlemen, don't you think that in artificial intelligence, you are seeing a replica, a small abstract of human intelligence? Human intelligence also does the same thing. He will gain knowledge, he will represent knowledge, he will plan, he will learn. This is called machine learning, actually. A machine has to learn from its past experiences. Let me come back to that topic. The natural language processing. This is able to read and understand human language by processing the human language into machine language. Are we not, as a human being, are we not going to a dog and try to find out what it requires? We are able to, even though we do not know the language of a dog, we are trying to understand it. So there is some processing, language processing is going on. You sit in your room and there is a wall. If the wall is white, don't you think wall is also talking to us? Is it not telling us that I am white, I am white? It may not be telling with its mouth, there is no mouth for a wall, but I am understanding that that wall is white in its color. There is language, barriers must be removed in intelligence. As far as possible, A deaf, dumb man has to be understood by others. So we need to have a processing methodology. And in particular, we have natural languages. The most dangerous thing in natural languages is they change from context to context. We know several words, they carry different meanings. Now we are going to simulate a human being into a machine. So whatever human body is doing, whatever human intelligence is doing, the same thing we have to do. We have to put in artificial intelligence machine. So for that one, we need to have natural language processing. Now the next is perception. This is also very important in artificial intelligence. We read a paragraph, but we don't try to understand, or we may not be able to understand. To be able to understand, we must have some effort. Not only effort, we must have our past experience. So the ability to use our input from sensors or microphones or wireless signals, or different aspects of the world. Wherever I am talking, any sentence, please compare it to human being. We have perception. We have very much perception. By seeing the face of a person, we have some perception that he is not happy. He is angry. He is very happy. He is smiling. Similarly, can we bring this concept to an artificial intelligence machine? What a beautiful concept we have in this perception. Next is speech recognition, virtual agent, machine learning, biometrics. Several things are there. I'm not going to talk about all those things. Think about your Google directions. Very interesting. It is an artificial intelligence. It is trying to relocate. Even if there is, suppose Google tells you that there is some rush here. There is a traffic jam is there. It is repositioning itself and it is readjusting itself and it is gaining knowledge from its past experiences. Already we are using this artificial intelligence, but are we able to put this into the brain of a student that this is not a new subject, this is nothing but our experience in dealing with the real world problems? And we have supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning, deep learning, these are all learning process. Actually, machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning. All these three are connected. Now new subject, there is a new nomenclature has been claimed as machine learning. But otherwise, earlier in AI itself, we used to teach machine learning and deep learning. What is supervised learning? Already somebody has studied it. Somebody has categorized it and somebody has put labels on it. What do you mean by it? Now you go to a market, a mall, there is some cooked food. On that there is a label that this is a cooked food from so-and-so and it can be eaten by using hot water. Everything is given. That is supervised learning. Then unsupervised learning. Supervised learning, the best thing is a child trying to learn walking in your house or trying to crawl. You will be there, you will be giving directions. And unsupervised learning, we leave them and we don't give any directions, we don't give anything, and he himself, he will learn. That's called what is known as unsupervised learning, child to walk, etc. Now in unsupervised learning, we ask the machine, what can you tell me about it? What do you know about it? You have seen or you have experienced this experiment. What is your opinion? That is called unsupervised learning. And then is reinforcement learning. So these are all not new ideas. They are all ideas which have been generated and we have done it. And in reinforcement learning, we tell to a student, if you do well, this problem correctly, I will give a chocolate or I will give a reward. If you fail in it, I will punish you. So we are reinforcing him. We are giving. Slowly the machine will start differentiate between right and wrong. The student will feel that if I fail, I have to stay for one more year. So this is a very important aspect in learning, reinforcement learning. And in this one, learner, he will go to the environment and he will take the input and there will be an action. If there is reward, you will be patted. If there is no reward, you will be punished. So the punishment must become an experience to you, and that will make you not to repeat next time. We are using this reinforcement learning in our house also. We are punishing our children. And if your child is studying well, we are rewarding him. We tell that, good, proceed, wonderful. We give him so many ideas. So now deep learning, it is imitating directly the human brain. Well, traditional machine learning are linear, deep learning algorithms stacked, increasing complexity and abstraction. It is depending upon artificial neural networks. Artificial neural networks, it is a mimic of human brain. It's a human brain mimic. Sorry that time is very fastly going out. I don't know. Tanvir, are you there? Already only 20 minutes are left. I have not yet started the subject. Tanvir?
Sir, I'm there, sir. So you can continue, sir. We have time, sir. We have 30 more minutes, sir. 30 to 40 minutes. Sir.
Yeah. Because
so you can continue.
I have not yet started. I don't know whether the lecture is interesting or not, but I have not yet started the lecture. The time is already getting down. Okay, no problem. Let us.
You can continue, sir.
Yeah. Now deep learning, and it is a type of machine learning, a subset of artificial intelligence. And machine learning is about computers being able to think and act with less human intervention. Whereas deep learning is about computer learning to think using structured model on human brain. This is also a part of artificial intelligence. I think by this time, most of the audience here are learned people, better learned than me. Only my ideas I am trying to put. If you feel that I am not putting in a right way, please forgive me. But this is what I understood. I understood from artificial intelligence. And I said, artificial intelligence is not a new subject. It is nothing but a sort of representation, or it is a simulation of human behavior. So for this one, we have supervised, unsupervised learning, design. And no, there are some problems with artificial intelligence also, because we have to construct, reconstruct. We have seen several machines are being sent back in most of the automotive cars. After sending to the market, they find some mistake and they will recall the mistake. They will recall the cars and they will repair it and send. There are problems, no doubt about it. And people have an apprehension that they may create what is known as unemployment. First of all, we must create an impression that employment in the modern world has increased in, I don't know, in how many number of times what it was when I was a student. When I was a student, for a job, 1,000 or 2,000 students used to apply. Now, 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, 16 lakhs people are applying. Even after the implementation of digital media and digital machines, the jobs have increased. Why? Because always comforts will demand new comforts. I'm not satisfied with my AC. When I was not having air conditioner, I was not happy. When I got air conditioner after 10 days, I'm not happy with my AC because I have to switch it off, switch on, increase, etc. Now what I am thinking, let the air conditioner read my body temperature and adjust to itself without my intervention. The air conditioner must, make the room congenial to my atmosphere. There is no end to the wishes. If wishes were horses, beggars will ride. This is the proverb. Now the world is going in that one. AI can cause employment. This is a myth. No, it will not cause. It will never cause. No. Then already I have given you what is known as the idea of advantages of artificial intelligence. Now, let me come back to the original creation of artificial intelligence. Why artificial intelligence is required? Because we have a problem, we have to start it, and we have to solve it. Every student has a problem, he has to solve. What is his problem? For fourth year, he must get some 95 to 100%. So first of all, he must understand what must be the input, what must be the output, and he must also understand what is his exact problem. Exact problem is he may not be understanding the problem, may not be understanding classes. If he does understand the classes, he is unable to analyze it. If he has analyzed, he is unable to retain it. If he is unable to retain it, he is unable to what is called infer it or inherit new. So the best example, best factor, the first primitive factor in artificial intelligence is identifying the problem. Several times we say, we'll ask us to our child or our friends, what is your problem? What is your problem? If a person cannot express his problem properly, we cannot search for a solution. So there must be a problem space. For this one, in your classroom, you will give so many examples. You will talk about chessboard, you will talk about eight queen problem, etc., etc. And we will talk about yesterday, I was a little bit surprised, the country was in frenzy. People were talking about the game between India and Pakistan T20, and everybody was talking their own problem space they have created. And in that problem space, they were trying to find out the solutions. So in intelligence, the problem space has to be identified. Example you can give, I want to come to a college. So problem is to go to a college. The problem space is, I have to get up in the morning, that is one goal. Brush my teeth, another goal. While I am brushing my teeth, the brush must be there, the paste must be there. If paste and the brush is not there, other mechanism must be there. I have what is known as a mechanism to travel to my college. For that one, I need a vehicle. If there is a vehicle, whether the petrol is there or not, somebody is disturbing, Mahalakshmi, somebody is disturbing.
Yes, I request participants to please mute yourself.
Mute yourself, please. So I have so much of problem. I need to have petrol. If there is petrol, is it sufficient for my journey? If it is sufficient, am I capable to take the journey? Like this, you go on, think about one small issue, coming to college is a problem, and that problem has different stages, different what is called tree structure methods. If you create that problem and write it on a piece of paper, coming to a college will have I don't think not less than 1,000 problems after coming to, after I boarding my vehicle, the traffic must be there. There should not be any disturbance. Is there any disturbance? Is there any alternate? Like this. So please think about this situation, gentlemen. So this is called problem space. The best thing in this world for any student or for any faculty or for any human being is to identify his problem and identifying the problem space. Whereas in artificial intelligence, we are creating a problem. We are asking it to solve it. For that one, we are also creating problem space. And we are asking it to search. So again, searching technology has come. That's why I say that all of you must give a wonderful dose of, a concentrated dose of data structures, database management systems, network theory in the second semester itself, if possible in second year itself. Then only introduce this subject. Then the student will have a very good idea about this subject. He must be given a wonderful idea about all these algorithm, what is data structure. And it's not a new subject, different from computer science. It is a part of computer science. Now people are talking about specialization. It's not specialization. It is only deviation from one road to another road. That's all. So here, the background must be given in a very clear manner to a student up to third semester, that is first year, first semester, second semester, second year, first semester. He should not be taught any other subjects, but the basic subjects which gives him about how to identify a problem, how to identify a problem space. This is very important. Then he must know how to formulate a problem, and how to formulate a goal, and can it be, I don't want to leave this, these are all problems, please leave it down because there is no time. And what may be the solutions, what are the things, what are the states? Gentlemen, if possible, finite automata also must be taught before artificial intelligence. Because there we talk about states. From one state to another state we have to go. We are actually, we are all going from one state to another state, from 10th state to interstate to BTEC state. In our house also, one state to another state. While eating, we have one state, next one state. It's all part of intelligence. There is a transition from one action to another action. If you take wrong step, you will go in wrong direction. Then what is searching? Searching a right path is searching. Searching for a goal is not searching. Searching a right path is searching. Naturally, it will lead to goal. If a student never bothers whether he gets 90% or 100% in his final year, but every day he attends class, every day he does his homework, every day he follows the lecture, every day he will answer your questions, every day he does all practicals in a correct manner and never tells what is your goal, he never tells. Don't you think he will reach to the goal? Without telling what goal is, he will reach faster than others. His path cost must be less. His path cost is very less because he is going in right path. When somebody is going in right path, don't worry about goal. It will reach. Whether you like it or not, you will be in goal. Right path only. So transition model, goal test, path test. So this is what is known as artificial intelligence basis, machine learning basis, deep learning basis. Now if somebody asks, sir, in what way it is connected with C language or Java language? Every language, what it is doing, are we not teaching searching technology? Are we not teaching data structure technology? I think same thing here also. Write a rule and write it in a program. Naturally, it becomes artificial intelligent program. Why do you bother about it as a new subject? It is not a new subject. It is an old, grand old subject. It took its birth when computer science itself has taken birth. Now, when the problem is being worked out, most important thing we must tell to a student, when a problem is posed, the first question you must ask, can it be decomposed? The problem is large. Can it be attacked directly or can it be attacked piecewise? Same thing we are doing in our little day-to-day routine life also. Is there any strategy somebody has approached with supervised learning? First find out supervised learning. Has somebody done this problem? Then why should we do this problem? We will use that knowledge, which is called heuristic. Heuristic means based upon others' knowledge, we will start doing the new knowledge. Either instead of following blind method, let us not follow it. Let us follow the straight method. Use others' methodology. But don't tell a student that always depend on guides or all-in-one, etc. That cannot be a good solution because he will be losing the path. Somebody is disturbing again. Hello? Who is that? Somebody, please. Right. Somebody is not muted. I'm extremely sorry.
I request all the participants to mute yourself, please.
Please. You are all faculty people. You must set goals. Next.
It's a request again.
Yeah, please. And if the desired solution is the state of world or path to a state, if somebody says, now there is a saying, we don't want big.
Sir, please unmute yourself, sir. We are unable to hear your voice. Unmute yourself, sir.
అన్మ్యూట్ చేసి చాలా ఇప్పుడు వినబడుతుందా? యా ఓకే రైట్. సపోజ్ సంబడి గివ్స్ యూ ఏ పాత్ బట్ నెవర్ టెల్స్ అబౌట్ ది గోల్, హీ హాస్ గివెన్ ఎ రైట్ పాత్, దట్స్ వండర్ఫుల్. హౌ టు అప్రోచ్ ఏ ప్రాబ్లమ్ హీ హాస్ గివెన్ వితౌట్ టెలింగ్ అబౌట్ వాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ఈస్. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ఆల్ 7-point క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎ ప్రాబ్లమ్. So the students must understand about these problems and the control strategy must be there. For this one, you need to have what is known as algorithm applications, how to work out algorithms, because it's all digitized world. We have to work in digital machines only. So we need to have goal step, etc., etc. I'm trying to rush the matter. Define the problem, analyze the problem, identify the problem, choose the solution, implementation. Dear faculty members, please bring them the idea of software engineering. In software engineering also, we are trying to tell them, first of all, try to find the feasibility. Feasibility means whether this problem can be solved. Before solving, whether it is technically feasible or financially feasible, are knowledgeably feasible or anything. So these are all most important problems. We have to do it. And then we have what is known as most important thing in this artificial intelligence, very, very important thing. They are informed searches and uninformed such as I hope you will check it in your subject. You will know about very simple techniques. I think we need not have any all these techniques. You are teaching them in data structures, or either you are teaching in database management system. In database management system, you are teaching them B plus trees, etc. In data structures, you are teaching best first search, search first search, best fit search, etc., etc. So all these things, you can ask one student. He has asked me a question. Sir, in artificial intelligence, you say that there is best first search, depth first search, etc. In that one, the methods are very clear. But in natural intelligence, we don't follow anything, but we get a goal. His question. My answer was, if it is natural intelligence, how you got the answer, nobody checks. Okay, no problem. But suppose if it fails, then what would be the catastrophe? There should not be a failing technique. In human intelligence, there is a chance of failure. But in artificial intelligence, which is created by us, there is no chance of failure. Unless you feed it good current, etc., etc. Now, there are several methods. One is a heuristic search, another is a blind search. Heuristic search, we depend on somebody's experience, then do it. Now, best example for heuristic search, a student listening your lecture, he need not prepare separately. You have prepared and you are teaching, he is gaining the knowledge. Same thing you are doing to an artificial robot also. You know the knowledge you have created in the brain of, in the machine, and machine is using. Where is the difference? Whatever your father has done, you are able to enjoy it because he has already done it. You are enjoying it and you are exchanging it. So don't you think that artificial intelligence is extension? It is an extension. It is an extension of the human intelligence. I don't say extension, but a simulation. Extension means you may ask me a question, sir, is it superior than human being? No, it cannot be superior than human being. Because human sense has so many factors which influence them. When I go to, I am doing a work, somebody disturbs me. My wife may come and pose a problem. My child may come and pose a problem. My health may not be good. My chair may not be ergonomically suitable to me. Or my body is not feeling well. Or the power would have gone. So many factors. But for an artificial intelligence machine, only power is important. Only one factor it will use. Then there is constraint satisfaction problem. Limitations we put on a problem and then do it. Whereas in human intelligence, we don't like limitations. We want solution, but no limitations. Everybody wants to pass BTEC with 100%, but nobody wants to follow the rules. Constraint satisfaction. So now you can tell, you can feel that artificially created intelligence is more straight and more powerful than natural intelligence. In solving a problem, only that, up to that only. Again, somebody has to feed it. So this is what is known as constraint problem. Then there is means end analysis. Means end. Every word you can see, it is a mixture of backward and forward search techniques. If possible, we'll move further to get a solution. If there is no solution, you must have a strategy to step back and then go further. A student failed. If he failed, we are not going to remove him from the college. We are giving him a chance to reappear. Supplementary. This is called means end analysis. I'm rushing the subject. Then representing the knowledge. There are several ways of representing knowledge, gentlemen. There are three types of representing knowledge. One is, I'm not talking about human being, I'm talking about artificial intelligence. One is script. What is this script? Very interesting script. Best example, all books you will get it. Going to a hotel, why do you go to hotel? Your pocket is full. Then the money with the hotel owner is nil. You put your money from your pocket into the drawer of your hotel owner. So your pocket became nil and his drawer became full. So what? You are hungry, you need some food. So you went there. After going there, you won't sing or song or anything. You will search for a chair, you will search for a table, sit there, ask for a menu. It's all a stereotype of method that is called script. Now suppose a robot is created. Whenever somebody comes, it has to say hello. Stereotype, script. In dramas and in cinemas, a script is written by the director or writer, and the actor has to follow that script. That's all. He can't say that I don't want to follow that script. This is called a script. So you write a script and ask the artificial intelligence machine to follow it. This is one method. Another is frame. Frame means a structure which consists of a collection of attributes. Gentlemen, I will just give you a wonderful example. Most of the audience here, they have not seen me completely physically. Somebody has seen me. But suppose you see me after some time, you might be, while I am giving a lecture, you might be checking the attributes of me. Some attributes would have impressed you and they are stored in your brain. Maybe my spectacles or my white hair or my kumkum bindi or my nose or my face or anything. After some 4 or 5 years, when I meet you, immediately my present frame comes and your brain searches for a similar figure which has been registered in your brain after some time. So you will try to compare the futures. So this is called frame structure. Some attributes are given. With that attributes, you will describe an entity of the world. For example, you know what is meant by a car. You say that it is a vehicle which transports, which moves mechanically, etc., etc. We give a frame is being created. So first of all, the student will have a frame of what is called his toy cycle, then original cycle, then cycle motor, then car. A frame is created. If something is moving, immediately his brain tells that this is a moving vehicle. Either it must be a car or anything. This is called frame. And then the best method is conceptual dependency. This is based on some concepts we try to find out. We try to find out what exactly is the methodology. Now, a very interesting aspect I will tell you, gentlemen. In computer science, they have identified some verbs. Based on those verbs only, the complete machine learning can be developed. Example. What are the examples? There are some examples. For example, M-trans, he will say. M-trans means mental transfer. Then information is being taken by you. Physical transfer. You have given some article to somebody, physically transferred. Ingest, understand. Spell or express our ideas. Like this, he has given some 14 or 15 words, or around 16 words. With these 16 words, the complete methodology of running a robot machine is being developed. Those verbs are known as conceptual dependency methods. gentlemen, I do not know how you are receiving my what is called lecture. Now I would like to go switch to other topic. Tanvir, if I switch to other topic, it will take some time. Shall we take the feedback? Any doubts we can ask, or shall we continue for another 5 or 10 minutes?
Yes, sir. We'll take queries from the participants.
Yeah. Because Tanvir, actually, I can give continuously 4 hours lecture on this topic.
I know it, sir. As one of the participant is been posting in the chat box that you are the legend of Kakatiya University. We are very happy to have you in our college, sir. It's our honor. It's a prestige issue for us, actually.
Please tell me.
Participants, if you have any queries or any questionnaire, sir is with us. You can ask the sir.
Sir, anything you can ask. Very important things, because all of you are teachers. If a lecture does not invite questions, that lecture is a boring lecture, number one. Number two, if a lecture does not instill confidence in others, that lecture is a waste lecture, number two. Number three, if a lecture does not create questioning and answer session, that lecture is not good. This concept I am practicing in my classroom also, because you need to train your students to question you. If there is no question, you are eating a food without salt and chili or any other thing. You are just eating white rice, that's all. So if possible, we'll take 5 minutes and we would try to answer your questions if you want. It sounds like you have said something. So
yes, sir. One of the participants has raised.
Yeah. What is that?
Yes, one of the participants has raised his hand. So I request them to ask the question, or you can post in the chat box. So
no, you can ask. You can ask a question. You can ask a question.
Yes.
Or people can put it in. Naveen, please. Naveen Kumar, please.
Yeah, hi, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I would like to know nowadays which tool or software or which software language is booming the AI industry. So if I want to learn any of the software language, want to become a data science in future. So please suggest me the which tool, or whether it will be the Python or SAP. Yeah, what would be the machine learning language you suggest?
Right. Good. Very good question, sir. Sir, first of all, you must understand which company you are joining. Number one, every company uses its own methodology. We don't know whether somebody uses Python. Recently, I have seen one company using C language for its machine learning. Very peculiar, but the best suitable language for artificial intelligence. There were other earlier. There were languages Smalltalk, there were languages Lisp, there were language Prolog, etc., etc. They were all artificial intelligence languages, but they were not suitable now because of their speed and other constraint. Now, to some extent, Python is suitable. R programming is also suitable, but I don't suggest that particular language is suitable. But if you have got good idea about any language, you can also create whatever algorithms you have done, you can create. But the trend is nowadays Python, and because I am seeing so many papers, published papers. Recently, I've seen a paper in which data analytics only through Python, that's what he has written, one author. So it's maybe Python and R programming to some extent with a grip on object-oriented programming. That would be nice for it. Okay, sir? Naveen?
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Absolutely fine.
Any more question? You can put it on chat box.
Sure, sir. Sure.
Right. Right.
So very good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, please.
My question is, on what basis we can have a difference between machine learning and AI techniques, sir? What actually the main difference?
Well, difference between machine learning and
AI.
AI. First of all, there is no difference, gentlemen.
But in general, they used to say that
I'll tell you, please.
Okay,
there is an ophthalmic surgeon earlier. Earlier, MBBS people used to see the eyes. He used to give prescription. Then came ophthalmic surgeons. Now in ophthalmology, there are different specializations. One is seeing only black, another is seeing only white, another is seeing only fundus, another is seeing only... So this is all specialization in a broad subject. The broad subject is artificial intelligence. Machine learning is developed on artificial intelligence. Number one, number two, it is an inherited object of the parent object, artificial intelligence. I'm talking in terms of object-oriented program. So first of all, you cannot directly teach machine learning. You must have an idea about what is artificial intelligence. Am I clear, Santosh?
Yes, sir. One more thing, sir. What actually is data science?
Data science is a blend. It's a blend of all these subjects. It is not a new subject. Already we are all doing data science. Earlier, one of the senior most software man was talking to me. Sharma sir, people are nowadays talking about data science. Whatever I have done in these 20 years is data science. So there is no different concept. Only thing is specialization. It is, again, it is also using AI techniques, etc. So there is no question. One building of a block from one block to another block is our concept. Data analytics, data science, it's not a new subject, but the background must be thorough, then anybody can inherit. I'm telling you, object-oriented programming is the concept, inheritance. You have to inherit. Old knowledge must be there and new knowledge must start. Right? Tanvir, shall we, Swati, Gauroj, please, madam. Some speaker, EBTS organization speaker is waiting. Swati, madam, please.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I have a small doubt. Please correct me if I'm wrong. I just heard something called transfer learning. Is it related to transfer learning?
Yeah. It's all part of it. No problem. Right.
Okay. So actually, what exactly it is, sir? Can you just give me a brief of it?
No, actually, I'm telling you, everything starts from artificial intelligence. You start with it and proceed. That's all.
Okay.
And Naveen has put another question. I am not from coding background. If I want to learn any of coding knowledge, what will be your suggestion? See, coding program, the word coding is programming. What is programming after all? Your marriage is a program. You will plan for a program. Is it not so? For that one, you have a starting, you have an ending, you have middle statements, and there are steps. Why do you worry about learning coding? Practice it, that's all, it will come. Positive attitude. Go and do it. PC and Seema Rajput, please, madam.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir, I asked one question.
Yeah.
Sir, I am beginner of this field. So how can I start the artificial intelligence?
What is your qualification, madam?
Sir, I am from M.Tech. I am doing M.Tech.
Wonderful.
And my branch is VLSI design.
No problem. M.Tech electronics, is it?
Yes, sir.
No, to start, I think you have some components of data structures and database management systems in your M.Tech, I hope. Just to start taking a book and then start doing it. There is nothing to worry about it. If I am sure, better read Rich and Knight book. That is a very good book. Rich and Knight, Artificial Intelligence by Rich and Knight. It will be a descriptive book. That will be a very good book. You can follow. And if you can take my address and then send me an email, I will answer what are the things which you have to read. Okay?
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hello.
PC,
No, I'm Pratibha Chaturvedi, sir. Good morning.
Actually,
I want to know, like, is there any good site where we can find scripts written in R or Python programming
on text mining, sir? Yeah. There are a number of sites.
So can I have, you
I don't know whether not immediately I can do, but I have noted them. You can contact me, ask me, madam. If you contact and mail, I'll give those answers. I have seen
it. Thank you very much, sir. I'll surely mail you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So the other speaker is waiting. I think I am sorry, I'm intruding. I have a complaint with Tanvir that you have given me less time. I am class savvy. Dear audience, I will conclude my lecture. This is my 51st year of continuous teaching. Please bless me, all of you. I am 71, still trying to learn. And with all your good hope and good encouragement, I hope I will learn the modern techniques in future also. Thank you. God bless you. Bye bye.
So sorry, sir, that we have given a very less time formalities by an Atal Academy. But we are very much blessed to have you in our institution. Thank you very much, sir, for giving a quick response and sharing your knowledge on a data and how to create a problem and enlightening us on the knowledge and the usage of artificial intelligence, machine learning and deep learning. You are actually a god to start a machine learning in our college. Actually, we have taken your footsteps only, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving us as the keynote speaker as well as the resource person for our first session. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
We have our second speaker, Arunjit Chaudhary, sir. Hope sir has been...
Good morning. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You are.